Hey guys, I just had my closest thing to a fatal near miss that I can remember in you know, as long as I can remember. So basically I was out on the bike, obviously it's like by far and away the most dangerous thing I do is ride the bike on the road. And we came down the hill, we came into a little town and there's a 30 mile an hour speed limit. And as you come into the town, the road straightens and levels out. And there's parked cars all along the left. There's no oncoming traffic, but there's a little turning, first turning on the right in this village, and that's the one I want. So I look behind me and I've got a clear four car lengths back to the car that's following me, which just happens to be a silver pickup truck. And I move out into the middle of the road, which kind of looks like I'm just passing the parked traffic. I'm slowing down, so I'm doing less than 20 miles an hour maybe, but I'm still moving at a decent pace for a cyclist. I don't check over my shoulder again. I'm like, four lengths, that's enough. He's not gonna reduce that four car length distance before I reach my turning. And as I'm coming to the turning, there's a car maneuvering in the entrance. It's coming out of a parking space or something. So I'm kind of focusing on that and I forget all about the traffic behind me. And then I pull into the turn. And as I do so, I hear like this noise behind me, this unmistakable noise of like basically four tires locking up. And it's the pickup. Basically, he was just moving to pass me and I must have pulled across right in front of his bonnet. And you know, as I'm just, you know, rolling into the turn, I'm still looking at this car maneuvering out of a parking space to make sure that I'm gonna clear that. And I hear the noise, I look around and I see the car, this pickup is like fully stopped and the driver's looking at me and I couldn't, it was too far away. I was moving so quickly, I was that far down into the turning by that time that I couldn't really see the expression on his face, because it's going to be one of two things. It's going to be either anger or it's going to be fear. But the anger in a situation like that is only because you don't want to feel fear. We don't like consciously decide to be angry so that we're not afraid, but when you're in your car, you're nice and relaxed, you're comfortable. And then this thing comes along and reminds him, holy shit, you know, people are mortal. This thing I'm doing driving is really fucking dangerous, right? And it's a reminder to me that cycling is dangerous too. But I am making a presumption here that this man lives in a space where like he could die. And, you know, more to the point here, he could, by no fault of his own, absolutely no fault of his own, but the thing is, I don't fear death. I have absolutely literally no fear of death. It doesn't mean I want to go out and do reckless things. I'm not about to you know, climb that tree. You know, that would scare the hell out of me. Climbing trees, it's something I've done in the past to face fear and to conquer fear. But we went sailing recently. I went sailing with Julie, my girlfriend. And well, she took me sailing really, because she's an experienced sailor, and it was, for me, it was my first time on like a big sailing, like a multi-crewed, it was a 40-foot yacht basically. And you know, you're managing the risk, and when that thing's leaning over and there's water coming in the side of the boat, that's pretty scary for a landlubber like me. And I just looked around and everybody in the boat was like chilled out. So I don't fear death, and many of us don't. Basically, death would be an easy way out from so many things that we can experience in life. Even when things are great, even when things are generally speaking going well and we've got this good things working out for us and there's a bright future, even then death would seemingly be an easy, could be conceived as an easy way out, because you're not going to have any problems anymore. It's going to be a release, and I honestly believe that's what it's going to be when it comes. But I don't fear death, because I know that it's not going to come soon for me. I can not literally see it, I haven't tried to visualize it, but I just know in my heart that I'm going to be a very, very old man. I'm going to be one of those old men who they look at and go, you know, you don't look a day over 70, and I'll be like 90. And they'll say, what's your secret? And I'll tell them all these weird little things, just fucking with them, like, oh yeah, you know, you've got to, you know, when you get up in the morning, you've got to stand on one leg and pat yourself on the head. I've done that every morning for the past 40 years. Maybe not all of us, but certainly some of us, and definitely myself, we have like contractual obligations, contracts with things that are outside of this realm of space and time. And I don't really know what that means, but it means that there are certain objectives that need to be fulfilled. There are certain lessons that must be learned, and maybe the things that are learned must be passed on before I can leave this place. So, okay, I could possibly learn and teach my lessons as a quadriplegic. Let's say that pickup truck was coming up a little bit quicker than he was. Losing my track again. Yeah, I could do that. I could do that as a quadriplegic from a hospital bed, but that's not going to be the case. I'm going to be a very fit 90-year-old, 100-year-old, 110-year-old. Very fit, very active. I know it. It's a contract. It's a contract with the great beyond. Yeah, this channel not long ago got past 100,000 views, and there are, I don't know, something like 1,300 subscribers now, which doesn't necessarily mean, I mean, it doesn't at all mean that 1,300 people watch every video I put out, but what it means is 1,300 individuals at some point have connected deep enough with something I've said to think, I want to hear more of what this person has to say. I realise that I have a choice to be like a positive, sharing positive ideas and positive information, or more negative, and I've done both, right? I've absolutely gone right down the middle of the line with that. It's been the suffering from an autoimmune condition, even though mine is relatively minor in the grand scheme of things, it just really twists you up. But yeah, I'm gonna drop the negativity. I am already doing it. This is the thing, right? The only way you can heal is you can't figure out why there's negativity in your mind and in your life. You just have to accept that it is there and then just let it go, just put it down. And not try to figure it out, not try to figure out where it comes from, not try to figure out why this relationship is antagonistic, or the fact that people do that, just people do that, whatever it is, and that's antagonizing you. Just don't try to figure it out. You can't resolve it. It's a reflection of something in you. You have to, you can't resolve it out there, but you do resolve it in here. And the way that you do that is by just reassimilating it back into yourself. Okay, we've fragmented ourselves and we've projected those fragments onto the world around us and onto people around us. So you just have to basically become okay with it all, bring it all back to the center, right? And I don't know if it's coming for everybody, but it, you know, we all feel like something's happening. Right, like we're approaching a singularity, collectively, individually, perhaps. I certainly do. I know it's coming, and I think that's what it is. I think it's reassimilation of all these fragmented parts that have just been projected outwards. They're all coming home to roost, and I'm just gonna find that deep acceptance and healing that's been missing. It's been ongoing for 7 years. In summary, don't fear death. Don't give in to negativity. Try to understand that everything is you and you are everything. It's not important. It's not possible to tell which is the original and which is the copy. That's how I find it. Okay? I think I'm just going to leave it there. I'm just going to try, basically, I'm going to try and... I know all this stuff, right? I'm just going to try and bring it back into my everyday life, rather than just conceptualizing these things. And obviously I'm gonna continue documenting things on YouTube. It's gonna be a bit more positive on the channel now, because I realized that I have to let go of the negativity in order to heal. I've needed it. It's done some great things for me. It's helped me to realize a lot, but it's time to let go of it. And singularity is coming very soon. So we have to welcome it. We have to prepare. Take it easy.